Viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. The topic which we are discussing today is from the subject cosmetics and cosmeceuticals, and it is the second part of the common problems associated with the oral cavity. We have discussed few problems in the part one. Now we are going to discuss the rest of the problems in this presentation, that is the common problems associated with the oral cavity part two. Next common disease associated with the oral cavity is the tooth erosion. It is actually the irreversible loss of the tooth structure due to the chemical dissolution by the acids. Please note that it is not due to the bacterial origin, but due to the acidic food, acidic drinks which is being consumed, having the pH below 5 to 5.7. These drinks are known to be triggering the dental erosion effects. Now, what are the causes? Causes are the accumulation of the food particles, accumulation of bacteria in the gelatinous mass. This mass is known as the plaque. It also results from the anaerobic fermentation of sugar in the saliva, which triggers the release of the lactic acid. Problem associated with the oral cavity is the staining of the teeth. Teeth can be discolored by the stains on the surface or by the changes inside the tooth. There are basically three main types of the tooth discoloration. Extrinsic, as the name suggests, it is on the outer part of the tooth. Drinks like coffee, tobacco, wine, cola, or other types of the drinks can stain the teeth. Smoking also causes extrinsic stains. Another part of tooth discoloration is the intrinsic type. This occurs when the inner structure of the tooth darkens or get a yellow tint. Third type is the age-related factor. This is a combination of both extrinsic and intrinsic factors. Dentin, which is the naturally as the age progresses, this dentin yellows over the time. The enamel that covers the teeth gets thinner with the age. When this gets thinner, that the dentin part becomes more visible, which allows the dentin to show through. Food and smoking are also causing factor for the staining of teeth as the people get older. Problem associated with the oral cavities are the general cavities, also known as the tooth decay, which results in the formation of hole-like structure in your tooth. Cavities start small and gradually becomes bigger when they are left untreated. Now, what are the symptoms of tooth cavities? Symptoms are tooth sensitivities, tooth pain, a yellow visible hole in your teeth, black or of white color. Now, what are the causes of the tooth decay? Tooth cavities are caused by the plaque, a sticky substance that binds to the teeth. Plaque is basically a combination of bacteria, saliva, acid, and food particles. Now, what are the treatment options? Treatment options are the tooth fillings, crowns, root canals, early stage treatment, and dealing with the pain. What are the complications from tooth cavities? A tooth cavity can cause a variety of complications if it is left untreated. These includes ongoing tooth pain, the development of pus around the infected tooth, and increased risk for breaking or chipping of tooth, and difficulty in chewing the food. A common disease associated with the oral cavity is the hyperodontia. As the name indicates, it is the presence of the extra teeth. Hyperodontia is the condition of having supranumerary teeth or teeth that appear in addition to the regular number of the teeth. So you can say it is an additional teeth. They can appear in any area of the dental arch and can affect any dental organ. Supranumerary teeth can be classified by the shape and also by the position. The shapes include the following: supplementary or tuberculate or conical or compound odontoma or complex odontoma. Now, they are being treated with the advanced cosmetic treatments. Problem associated with the oral cavity is the thrush. The immune system and the body's normal bacteria usually keep the candida in balance. When this balance is interrupted, it can result in an overgrowth of the candida fungus, causing thrush, a yeast infection of the mouth or the throat. It is caused by the species of candida albicans. Now, what is the treatment for this? The commonly used drugs like fluconazole, clotrimazole, itraconazole, which are oral antifungal drugs, are used for the treatment. Nystatin, which is an antifungal mouthwash, is also used along with the therapy. Amphotericin B, which is a drug used to treat the severe infection, is also prescribed. Common disease associated with the oral cavity is the malocclusion. A malocclusion is a misalignment or incorrect relation between the teeth of the two dental arches when they approach each other. As the jaws close, the common causes are they are basically present at the time of the birth and can manifest as a space between the teeth or irregular jaw or mouth size or even a cleft palate. It can also be acquired from habits such as thumb sucking, tongue thrusting, premature loss of the teeth from an accident or dental disease, or medical conditions such as enlarged tonsils and adenoids that lead to mouth breathing. General causes are the genetic factors, environmental factors, or the overactivity of the dental lamina during the tooth development. The treatment proposed is to detect, evaluate, and treat supranumerary teeth as far as possible. It is tried to remove the teeth as far as possible, or other advanced medical cosmetic treatments are also done. Another common problem associated with the oral cavity is the torus mandibularis. Torus mandibularis is a bony growth in the mandible along the surface near to the tongue in the oral cavity. It's just a benign condition, which is not life-threatening actually. These single growths are made of bone, non-movable, smooth and hard to touch. It is believed that torus are the results of the local stresses and genetic influence. Their growth is up to 2 mm to 4 cm depending on the person-to-person specific condition. Common problem associated with the oral cavity is the lingual thyroid. Lingual thyroid is a rare clinical entity of the oropharyngeal region caused by the failure in descendants of the thyroid gland to its normal position during embryogenesis. It is a general condition where thyroid tissues are seen in places other than the tongue. It can occur in any age, but usually seen in the teenage. The symptoms associated are the bleeding from the mouth, sleep apnea, hypothyroidism, and foreign body sensation. One problem associated with the oral cavity is the cheilitis. Angular cheilitis is a condition that causes red, swollen patches in the corners of the mouth where lips meet and make an angle. It can be on the one side of the mouth or on both the sides. Actually, it is a fungal infection caused by the type of yeast called Candida, the fungus that causes diaper rash in babies. Now, the symptoms associated are the irritation or soreness in the mouth or bleeding or blistered, cracked, red, scaly, swollen conditions. Sometimes lips feel like burning sensation or maybe related to the weight. So as of now, we have studied all the common problems associated with the oral cavity. Now, rare diseases which are also linked up with the oral cavity are the congenital condition. These are the conditions present at the time of the birth, or other inflammatory lesions or traumatic conditions, or autoimmune disease, or precancerous lesions, leukoplakia or erythroplakia, or benign tumors of the oral cavity. So as of now, we have studied all the common problems associated with the oral cavity. Watching my video, please do like, share, and subscribe. Please provide your comments in the comments box. Thank you.